racist comments on Facebook revealed, prompting the resignation of a woman who was working for the Republican Party in Beaver County, Pennsylvania. Now, according to the Beaver County Times, Carla Maloney called NFL players who kneeled during the anthem baboons and ignorant blacks in posts on her private Facebook page, posts that have since been removed. And here's one of those posts. Steelers are now just as mad as the rest of the overpaid baboons. You respect your flag, country, and our national anthem. How many men and women have lost limbs or died to protect this country, and you baboons want respect? If you want respect, you need to earn it, and so far you haven't. Stop watching or going to a game and paying for overpriced food, water, and tickets. Let's see how the baboons get paid when white people stop paying their salaries. Joining us now, CNN political commentator and Temple University professor Mark Lamont Hill. And also joining us by phone, former NFL player Walter Dunson. Walter, let me start with you. It's difficult for me to read that. I'm so offended personally at this point. Does any of this surprise you, and what is your reaction?
Well, you know, none of it surprises me at all. We had this conversation almost a year ago as it pertains to the president. The president has made, you know, people feel like it's okay to not only voice their opinion about this, but also, as we see now, to write their opinion even in a public area. And we're talking about public officials at that. You know, as players, we're just taken aback about all of this. You know, our goal isn't to be disruptive by any means or anything like that. We just want to. We just stand with Kaepernick and trying to make sure that everybody understands that we are standing against police brutality. And that's what it's all about for the NFL players.
Mark, Carla Maloney was not only a GOP official, she also came on CNN identifying herself as a Trump supporter. And I wonder, is this what you were worried about? I mean, is this what you have been speaking about in terms of the Trump administration inciting racial division?
Absolutely. It's two things. On the one hand, it is, as a matter of fact, what the Trump administration has helped produce. They have normalized a culture where you can call NFL players baboons, where you can question their patriotism, where you can question their humanity, and where you can make NFL owners seem like they don't own teams, but that they own people. And the second part of it, though, is that for many people, this feels like the explicit articulation of what Trump subtly says in his tweets, what he subtly says in his remarks, when he calls them SOBs, when he talks about how lucky they are to be in the NFL, when he talks about getting rid of them. All of these sort of things feel like almost like she feels like Trump unplugged, like what the inner workings of Trump's mind are. Now, again, that's my speculation, but the subtext of what he says and the context of what he says resonates very strongly with what this woman said very clearly. And that's why many of us have anxiety with what the Trump moment and the Trump administration has produced.
Let me read you another one of her posts. She says, "Tired of these overpaid, ignorant blacks telling me what I should believe in. I will tell you what I believe in, and that is our flag and national anthem and America, period, end of story. You don't like it? Here, go to Africa. See how you like it there. We are all Americans, not African American, not Hispanic American. We are all American." Walter, she only resigned after these posts went public.
I mean, that's what I understand. These words are just extremely, extremely disrespectful. Disrespectful to her office, you know, as she walked into the office. It's also disrespectful to us as African Americans. It's just a disrespectful period. Whether we're black, white, or whatever, that isn't what we're here to do, and that's not what we're about. Again, the protest, you know, from the player standpoint, is only about police brutality. We're not interested in anything else other than that. We're trying to bring the light to that situation, trying to better that situation, not only locally, but also nationally as well.
In her resignation letter, Mark, she writes, "While it does not change the fact that the words were mine and mine alone, the fact that these posts were made public were the result of an ongoing family dispute." Does that give you any empathy for her?
No, she got outed being racist by somebody who doesn't like her. Now, whether or not they have reason not to like her outside of these posts, I don't know. That's their family business. But I have no empathy that a racist gets outed as racist because someone who did it might also be a jerk too. I'm more concerned with the fact that had a family member not outed this woman, we would have someone in public office who believes and feels these things, and also that there may be, in fact, there are numerous people, whether they're private citizens or public officials, who also carry these beliefs, who will never know about, but who have an influence in public policy, who have an influence in the public discourse, and who help shape and reflect thoughts that go, political thoughts that go all the way up to the White House. That's what scares me, not that she got outed.
Mark, the NFL season kicks off this Thursday where you are, in Philadelphia. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if you were there. What do you expect this season in terms of anthem protests, owner reaction, and of course, President Trump?
Well, you should be surprised if I'm there. I'm boycotting the NFL this year as I boycotted last year. I didn't even watch the Super Bowl, although the Eagles did win the Super Bowl and the Cowboys did not. I want to make that very clear. But the Eagles got to rub with Dallas. But no, I don't watch the NFL until Colin Kaepernick has a job, until Reed has a job. I will not watch the NFL. But what I do expect, what I hope to read and watch on CNN, is that numerous NFL players have protested. And if the NFL players have the political courage that I pray they have, all of them will be on one knee when the season starts. Because until Kaepernick has a job and until racial justice has been properly addressed by the NFL, not fixed, but properly addressed, nobody should be standing up. Everybody's body should be at half mast.
Mark Lamont Hill, Walter Dunson, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.